This is a 360 photo captured by the Insta360 One RS 1-inch, and this is Flow 10K 360.
Wow, this is professional level quality with a cell phone gimbal. No way!
Are you a 360 photographer who just got the brand new Insta360 Flow because of the hype and quickly realized the Flow can only take 6K 360 photos with stitching air like this? Don't throw your Flow into your trash can just yet. This in-depth virtual tour masterclass will help you get better 360 results than a professional DSLR. We will teach you what to get and how to shoot to avoid stitching artifacts, how to get the highest quality individual photos out of your Flow, and get the perfect stitching for a professional virtual tour. This is easily the best 360 virtual tour invention in 2023. Let's learn how to use it correctly from a pro. First, we'll find out which is the best 360 camera, virtual tour camera in 2023. Insta360 Flow with the iPhone 14 Pro Max right here, or the Insta360 One RS 1-inch 360 camera right here, or a professional DSLR like the Canon R5 with a Nodal Ninja. Let's compare and find out. Here, from top to bottom, we have the Insta360 One RS 1-inch 360 capture in night bracketed HDR in 6K, the best setting for virtual tour. The middle is Insta360 Flow with the iPhone 14 Pro Max, arguably the best cell phone for photos, and the bottom is full-frame DSLR with Nodal Ninja 6. Let's punch into the focus chart. We can see that both Flow and DSLR has way better dynamic range than the HDR version of the One RS 1-inch. The color is also more accurate. Let's zoom into me. I am standing at the stitch line. My face is stretched because of the optical flow stitching on the One RS. Both Flow and the DSLR is very true to life in terms of object shapes and sizes. The resolution 10K versus 6K is a huge deal in virtual 360 photo. Even with a YouTube compression, you can see that the Flow and the DSLR is clearly winner in terms of details and image quality in close-up. The DSLR is better without small sensor compression artifacts, but in the stitch line area, we do see purple outline around very contrast area, like me here, this chromatic aberration artifacts. My DSLR has only captured 4 photos with a very wide fisheye lens. The Flow capture with my iPhone wide-angle lens automatically in 18 photos. I can pick the best section of each photo to stitch out a 10K output without any chromatic aberration. So, if you enjoy an easier, simpler workflow, or you are not a professional photographer but want the professional photo quality, then Insta360 Flow with the latest iPhone or Android phone is really the best 360 photo camera out there. But as I pointed out earlier, you cannot use the in-mobile app stitching on your phone. The in-app stitching only gives you 6K output, same as One RS 1-inch, and the AI is actually very bad at stitching. There are stitching error in every 360 photo I take. Before we learn how to fix that stitching artifacts in post, let's see what you can do to avoid stitching errors. How to shoot with Flow. As you see, the AI is turning the Flow to capture 18 individual photos. If the support system is not rock solid stable, then the gimbal will introduce off alignment when the photo is captured, and it cannot stitch well in app. Sometimes in a strong wind situation, the air can be huge like this, make your photo unusable. So never ever use the built-in plastic tripod leg or extendable pole like this. And also, don't use the invisible plastic selfie stick from your X3 camera. All those are not stable support system when the gimbal is moving and doing its thing. What I have here is the Bushman VR pole with a weight in the base, but you don't need an expensive heavy system like this though. I will recommend the Unize Chafo tripod with the Falcam F22 quick release system. It will help you quickly switch from handheld gimbal mode for video to on tripod 360 mode. A tripod will give you solid support even in strong wind. Check out this review right here if you are interested in an affordable carbon fiber travel tripod. The second very important point is to keep your gimbal level to the ground. My Unity tripod has a physical bubbler here to make sure the system is level, so the gimbal is not doing extra balancing when turning to uneven location. The third point is to balance your gimbal correctly. Follow your on-screen instruction to attach your cell phone holder exactly here. Make sure to set your timer to 10 seconds to give your gimbal enough time to self-stabilize. If you know how to shoot manual exposure setting to dial in your ISO, shutter speed, and white balance, do that. It will make your photo look a lot more professional. If not, please at least keep your shutter speeds, this right here, faster than 1/60. This helps avoid motion blur and give you a sharper 360 photo with an easier time stitching, with AI or manually. The most important and hidden feature that Insta360 don't want to tell you is the ability to save the individual image just like a professional DSLR. This is hidden under three dots on the top left corner. Scroll down to the end and turn on Save Unstitched Pano Photos. While you are at it, turn on the histogram as well to help you nail manual exposure. Right here in photo mode, select 360 photo, then you are ready to capture 360 photos. You can charge your phone with the Flow, but you need a fast charging solution to charge your Flow, especially when you are doing 360 photos, which will draw more power. I really love the see-through design of the Flow, so I want to find a power bank that can match it. And I found one on the internet. This is Sheer Greek Storm 2 Cyberpunk style transparent design 100 watt power bank. It can fast charge your Flow, and as you see right here, how much voltage going into the gimbal. When shooting an indoor virtual tour, Flow has another advantage. You can light your scene behind your camera to reduce noise. Here is with light, here is without light, with light again, without light. As you see, the quality difference is dramatic. You will need a pretty powerful light to light a big space. I recommend the brand new Molux X100 100 watt light from Ziyun. It comes with a small softbox to diffuse the light. I can carry the entire setup with only one hand to go with the fast gimbal movement. The only problem is power. The light takes 100 watt input to get full power. That is why I have the Sheer Geek Storm 2. This is the only reliable mobile power solution that can power the Ziyun light. Make it perfect run and gun lighting solution for indoor 360 virtual tour for the Flow. How to stitch 360 photo. Now let's learn how to get that 10K super high quality 360 photos. I like to use iPhone. Go to your phone, select all 18 photo using AirDrop onto your computer. Organize them into a single folder. This is optional. Having individual photo allow you to really edit each photo to the best quality before stitching. This is how all the professional photographers get their stunning 360 photo that have thousands of likes and share on Facebook 360. For example, you can open the latest Lightroom right here to remove chromatic aberration. I put them in Photoshop. In Photoshop, in the latest beta version, you can use AI Magic Removal 2 to remove me entirely with the power of AI. So if you are capturing outdoor and you don't want any tourists in your 360 photo, that is how you do it. This feature is currently in beta. If you want an in-depth tutorial on how to use it with 360 photo, drop a comment down below. If you are lazy, you can just drop all your 18 photos onto Topaz Photo AI and upscale them to get 20K and even 100K gigapixel panel. We are not gonna do that in this tutorial, but I want to show you how much further you can go to improve your 360 photo when you get individual unstitched photos. Now, let's learn how to stitch them. It is actually very easy. The best software to use is PTGui. I would suggest PTGui Pro, which has masking and HDR. You don't need Pro for this tutorial, but it's my secret weapon for DSLR virtual tours. Drop in all the 18 JPEG photos into PTGui. PTGui already have a profile for iPhone 14 and know all the metadata of your photos captured by the Flow. See here, click OK. Go ahead to hit the Align Image button and let PTGui do the magic for you. After it is done, PTGui will open up Panorama Editor. If you have the Pro version, you can use Find Optimus Themes right here. I turn this off for now. The result is already almost perfect. There is some minor misalignments here, like on the tripod. Usually, people will now go into adding manual control points to fix the issues, but I find it easier to just use the mask tool right here to fix minor issue like this. We can see photo number 2 has the full tripod leg. We just use the green brush tool right here to paint over the tripod leg to tell PTGui AI to use this entire portion and figure out the rest. Go back to the panel editor. Like magic, PTGui fixed the broken leg issue. We also noticed some misalignment on the cable right here. Photo 18 has almost the full sky, so we just asked PTGui to keep all the cable here in photo 18. It figured out everything again for us. Super smart software and generally underrated. By the way, this is not a sponsored video. I have been using PTGui as a virtual tour professional for the past 8 years now. Ask any successful Pro 360 photographers who are not BS YouTubers, who have been in the community for a while. They will tell you the same thing. I'm just sharing my secret weapon so you can too create beautiful 360 photos. Here, I am using PTGui Exposure Fusion and Tone Mapping tool to get the HDR result without capturing HDR. This will increase your dynamic range greatly when you boost the shadow and drop the highlights. That is why my shadows and highlights look so much better than the Insta360 Flow app output. I am sharing so much of my secret techniques. You should consider giving this video a like and follow me on Instagram as well to learn more. Now, go to Create Panorama tab. See the stitch result is 10K right here. Select TIFF, choose 16-bit non-compressed render. We are going to further edit it in Affinity Photo or Photoshop. Hit Create Panorama. Open Affinity Photos 2, drop in the stitch photo, turn on Light Projection. We see a minor stitch problem on the ceiling. No problem, we go back to PTGui to fix it. More chance for you to learn. This time, let's use control points. We see 14 and 18 has only one control point. That is why the ceiling is misaligned. Let's find some similar features on both photo and let PTGui know they are the same points. Optimize the stitching. Look a lot better now. Render and go back to Affinity Photo 2 to check. Good enough. You can spend more time to find more control points, generally give you a better result. But now let's move on. We are going to output a 10K JPEG from Affinity Photo, open EXFixer to inject metadata. Sorry, EXFixer software is off screen right now. Now just open up Facebook or any virtual tool software you use and upload the 10K, tone mapped it, Insta360 Flow, 360 Photo, and wait for all the likes come in from your friends and clients. This is how you get the best 360 photo with your iPhone and Insta360 Flow. Having 10K 360 photo will make your virtual tour business stand out compared to your competitor who shoot with the X3 or the 1RS 1-inch. I talked to Insta360 developers at NAB this year, and they will continue the development of Flow to unlock the usage of a high-quality 1x lens on your phone and allow saving DNG RAW file directly onto your phone. We also consider supporting HDR directly on the phone using iPhone Lidar to get depth map and the same output as a metaphor, or creating 3D 360 photo on 3D Vista using the Lidar depth map. We are even playing idea like NeRF
capture like Luma AI and photogrammetry. This is an AI gimbal and it should support NeRF AI. All this require community requests, the best way to show your interest in supporting my AI thesis and my push on Insta360 engineer team is through your comments. Request your feature, upvote others on the YouTube comment section down below. Insta360 is keeping their eyes on my comment. As you know, I'm one of the few who is trying to offer real knowledge to give back to the virtual tour community. So, support me by subscribing to this awesome YouTube channel. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss cool tutorials just like this one. I also want to thank my loyal viewers for continuing to challenge me in AI and XR research in 360, so I can offer something unique on this channel to make a positive impact to the community. Well, the next tutorial is even better. It is about AI in XR. See ya. That's right.